Jai Rao, myself Sachin Kumar, and in this video we are going to discuss about the network models. If we talk about the computer networks, then fundamental aspects are the network models. Networking is based on the network models. So primarily we have two network models. Number one, OSI reference model, and number two, TCP/IP reference model. So in this video, we are going to discuss about the OSI reference model. When we talk about the reference model, then it is based on the concepts of the layer. We have to study here multiple layers. And when we talk about the OSI reference model, it consists of the several layers. And the TCP/IP reference model consists of the four layers. And some in a few books it is written. Five layers. When we talk about the layer task, the layer basically contains well-defined functions of similar type. Say we are talking about the layer one. The layer one contains various functions. Every layer consists of the various functions, and these functions are related to each other, similar type. So we use the concept of layer in our daily life. As an example, let us consider two friends who communicate through postal mail. The process of sending a letter to a friend would be complex if there will be no service available from the post office. So if we are dispatching a letter from sender to receiver, then post office plays very important role. The entire execution part is done by the post office. The sender job is to dispatch only. And how letter will be dispatched to the receiver? What are the functions, what are the processing is involved in between? So this job is performed by the post office. And finally, letter is dispatched to the receiver. So letter posting, we have three components. Components are sender, receiver, and post office. So same concepts are implemented in the computer networking. In the reference model, we have here sender, receiver, and in between a carrier sends. So here we have sender at one side and receiver at the other side. Right here, sender, we have here higher layers, we have here middle layers, and we have here lower layers. So we have here layers, three types of layers in between the sender and receiver. First one is the higher layer, second one is the middle layers, and third one is the lower layers. So this one is the higher layer. So the job of the higher layer is the letter is written, put in envelope, and dropped in a mailbox. After it, the letter is carried from the mailbox to a post office. So this is the job of the middle layer. And finally, the letter is delivered to a carrier by the post office. So this is the job of the lower layer. So these tasks are performed at the sender side, and all similar kinds of tasks are performed at the receiver side. So at the receiver, when initially messages come from lower layer to receiver lower layer, and here the letter is delivered from carrier to the post office. After it is transmitted to the middle layer, where the letter is carried from the post office to the mailbox. And finally, from the middle layer, data is forwarded to the upper layer at the receiver side. And here the letter is picked up, removed from the envelope, and the rate. This job is performed at the receiver side. Same jobs are performed in the reference model. The first model that we are going to discuss about, this is the OSI reference model, and it is based on the concept of the layered architecture that we have discussed. And the peer-to-peer process is performed here, and whenever data coming from upper layer to lower layer, we have to follow the process. This process is called the encapsulation. So when we talk about the OSI reference model, we have here 7 layers. Layers are physical layer, data link layer, the network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, application layer. So total we have here 7 layers, and the user sits to the application layer. Application layer is the most close to the user. And when we talk about the physical layer is close to the system. So data is forwarding from up to bottom. I mean, data is coming from application layer, then presentation layer, then session layer, then transport layer, network layer, data link layer, and physical layer. So every layer has well-defined functions. So in this video, we are going to discuss about detailed functions of these layers. And this is basically, interaction between layers in the OSI reference model. So we have here device A, we have here device B. So device A is basically here sender, and device B is basically here receiver. And at the sender side, we are seeing here, we have the total 7 layers, physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, and application layer. All 7 layers are implemented at the receiver side, and in physical layer to application layer. And in between sender and receiver, in between device A and device B, lot of intermediate nodes are involved. These intermediate nodes may be the router, gateways, etc. So we have here first intermediate node, and this one is here second intermediate node. And when we talk about the intermediate node, so at the intermediate node, 3 layers are responsible: physical layer, data link layer, and network layer. So at the intermediate node, three layers plays the important roles. I mean, there is no roles of the upper 4 layers. So this is a very important point. At the center side, all 7 layers plays the important role, and at the receiver side, all 7 layers are plays the important role. And when we talk about the intermediate nodes, then we have only 3 layers. These layers are physical layer, data link layer, and network layer. So we have here also the interface. Application layer is called the 7th layer. Presentation layer is called the 6th layer. The numbering is also here mentioned. And these are the standard basically. So when we talk about the layer 1, this is the physical layer. When we talk about the layer 2, this is the data link layer. So in between 2 layers, we have the interface. I mean, when data comes from application layer to presentation layer, so we have the interface. Interface is 7-6. I mean, data is coming from 7 layer to 6th layer via the interface 7-6. Similarly, in between the presentation layer and session layer, we have the interface 6-5. So we have here, interfaces in between 2 layers. So this scenario is happened at the sender side and at the receiver side. When we talk about the transmission of data, as we have pointed out, user is sitting at the application layer. So initially data is coming from application layer to presentation layer, then presentation layer to session layer, then session layer to transport layer, transport to network, network to data, and finally physical layer. And after reaching to the physical layer, wires are connected to the physical layer. So here, data is reaching to the buyer. If we are following the buyer scenario, if we have the wireless scenario, then data may arrive to the ear. So this is the here buyer scenario. So data is coming to the, you know, physical medium. Physical medium may be, you know, twisted pair, coaxial cable, optical fiber, etc. And we have here, you know, now after reaching to the data at the intermediate node, so we have here a physical layer. Certain operations are performed at the physical layer, then operations are performed at the data link layer, then network layer. And finally, after performing the, you know, these operations, and now data comes to the, once again, physical layer, goes to the second intermediate node. After reaching to the second intermediate node, same operations are performed here. I mean, physical layer operation, data link operation performed, network layer operations are performed, and finally data is received at the receiver. And after getting the packet at the receiver side, data is reached to the physical layer of receiver side. After it, data is processed and data is forwarded to the data link layer, then network layer, then transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, and finally application layer. So when we talk about this interaction, so we are observing here data is coming from application to physical layer at the center side, and at the receiver side, data is forwarded from physical layer to application layer at the receiver side, and in between these importing layers, we have the senders, we have the intermediate nodes, and at the intermediate nodes, only three important layers play the important roles, and that we have pointed out: physical layer, data link layer, and network layer. So this is a scenario how data is transmitted from physical layer to, I mean, from sender to receiver. And if we observe this scenario, then upper four layers, transport layers to application layer, these are the end-to-end. End-to-end means transport layer to the application layer. These layers are applied at the sender side as well as the receiver side. And these layers are not applied in between the intermediate nodes. So therefore, upper four layers are end-to-end. And lower three layers are not end-to-end. I mean, lower three layers are implemented in the intermediate node. This is the classification between upper four layers and lower three layers. After it, we are demonstrating here, you know, exchange, how data is, exchanged using the OSI reference model. How data, you know, is encapsulated here. What is the meaning of the encapsulation, and how encryption encapsulation part done here. So we are observing here. So we have here data, and initially data is at, at the layer 7. This layer is called, data is called here D7. So we have mentioned here D7, and every layer has own header. So data is here D7, and header of layer 7 is added to this data, and this header is called S7. Header basically contains the control information, and data is our actual data. So we need here also the control information. I mean, what operations we have performed on the data. So these things are mentioned in the header file, header part. So header is very important part. So without header, we cannot imagine about the, reference model. All the operations that we have performed, what kind of the operations we have performed, this is taken from the header itself. The header plays very crucial role in the OSI reference model, or in any reference model, or in networking. So we have here, S7, D7. S7 is here about, you know, header part of layer 7, and D7 is the data part of layer 7. So it becomes S7, D7, I mean data is represented in this form at the layer 7. After it, data comes to the layer 7, and at the layer 6, entire L7, D7 parts becomes the D6. It becomes the data at the layer 6. And we have to add the header of layer 6. So we are adding the header of layer 6. So it becomes H6 and D6. So this H6 and D6, you know, is represented in the layer 6 when this packet, this message comes to the layer 5, the entire S6 D5 becomes the D5, and header of layer 5 is added. So this is here H5. H5 is added. So in this way, you know, we are adding. So this is the basically here encapsulation process. Whatever is coming from the upper layer, we are adding here header of the lower layer. I mean, things are encapsulated. We are just covering. We are just performing the envelope. We are adding here envelope to our, you know, our data that is coming from the upper layer. So this operation is being performed here. And when data comes, you know, from upper layer to lower layer, and at the bottom, data arrives at the physical layer. At the physical layer, we are representing the data in form of the 0 and 1. This is here our actual, you know, this is our final data. And this data is transmitted through the transmission media. It may be virtual wire, optical fiber, or twisted pair, etc. It may be any wire transmission medium. And finally, data is reaching to the receiver. This is the receiver scenario. So whatever the data we have at the sender side, at the physical layer, same data at here, at the physical layer of the receiver side. And at the sender side, we have performed the encapsulation operation. And at the receiver side, we have to perform the de-encapsulation operation. I mean, now here we have to the same data of sender side and the receiver side at the D2, I mean at the layer 2. Now we have to decapsulate here. So we have to remove the header S2. So we have to remove the header. And finally we have here S3 and B2. In this way we are performing all the operations. And finally data is arrived at the, you know, layer 7. The data is here S7 and D7. So this S7 and D7, you know, is data at the layer 7. And finally, header of this header is removed. S7 is removed and D7 is forwarded to the receiver. This is here our actual data. So this process we are following whenever we are implementing the concept of the OSI reference model. I mean, in this way, data is exchanged. But important point is here, whenever data is, you know, transmitted from sender to receiver, at the sender side, we are performing the encapsulation operation. And whenever data is receiving at the receiver side, we are performing the de-encapsulation operation. This job is being performed. And when we talk about the intermediate node scenario, then we may have here, you know, physical layer, data link layer, and network layer in between. So same encapsulation and de-encapsulation job is performed in between, you know, in between nodes. It will be routers or gateway, etc. So we have to perform, you know, encapsulation operation or de-encapsulation operation, etc. at the intermediate nodes also, because headers plays here, you know, very important role. And as we have pointed out, only header tells to us what we have to perform and how operations can be performed. This is determined by the header only. And now we are going to discuss about the functions of every layer. So as we have pointed out, total we have 7 layers, physical layer to application layers. Now, what are the functions of every layer? So we are going to discuss about these functions layer wise. I mean, what are the functions of the physical layer? What are the functions of the data link layer? What are the functions of network layer? And what are the important functions that are available at the transport layer? We are going to discuss about the functions and responsibility of each layer. So every layer is responsible for certain tasks, and to implement, to achieve this responsibility, we have to perform certain functions. So we need here to define the functions and responsibility for every layer. The first layer, very first layer, is called the physical layer. And this is the scenario of physical layer. So when we talk about the physical layer, data is coming from the data link layer and it is reaching to the physical layer. And at the physical layer, we have here, bit streams. The bit streams are here. So the job of the physical layer is to transmit the bit stream from sender to receiver. So we have here, transmission medium. The transmission medium is attached with the physical layer. So the job of the physical layer is basically, the job of transmission medium is to transmit the data from sender to receiver. And transmission medium is connected to the physical layer only. The responsibility of the physical layer involves in the actual transmission from sender to receiver. Sender to send the data from, sender to receiver in form of the 0 or 1 or in form of the signals. Whatever the transmission media we are using, if we are using the analog transmission medium, then data is represented in form of the analog signals. If we are using the digital transmission medium, then data is transmitted in form of the 0 and 1. It depends what transmission media we are using here. And when we talk about the responsibility of physical layer, the responsibility of the physical layer is movement of individual bit from one hop to the next. So how individual bits are transmitting? So this is the responsibility of the layer one. And layer two is here data link layer. And this is a scenario of data link layer. We have your data and we have your header and we have your frame. And data is basically represented in form of the frame. A data link layer. Entire this segment is called here frame. This frame consists of the data plus the header part of layer 2 and tail part of the layer 2. And data is coming from network layer, and from network layer, when data comes at the data link layer, it becomes the frame. And finally, data is transmitted from data link layer to physical layer. So this is the job responsibility of the data link layer. To transmit the data from network layer to physical layer. And same scenario is implemented at the receiver side. Data is being forwarded from physical layer to network layer. And when we talk about the responsibility of the data link layer, so data is link layer is responsible for moving frames from one hop to the next. So we have here hop-to-hop transmission. I mean hop-to-hop transmission means we have here one hop, we have here second hop, these two hops are connected. So how data is transmitted from this hop to this hop, and then this hop to further next hop, like this. So how data is transmitted, so we are have here these functions. This is the responsibility of the data link layer. Thank you.